वाला इन लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस अबाउट आइसोमॉर्फिक ग्राफ्स. सो इन टुडे क्लास वन मोर एग्जांपल ऑन आइसोमॉर्फिक ग्राफ्स. सो शो दैट the two graphs g1 and g2 are isomorphism or not. The two graphs are isomorphism or not. So what is isomorphism? How to find the given graphs are isomorphic or not? First we have to check both the graphs have the same number of vertices and both the graphs have the same edges and both the graphs have the one-one correspondence between the vertices and the edge preserving is also satisfied between the two graphs. So smallest possible cycle length is same for two graphs. Adjacency matrix of two graphs should be the same. These are the conditions have to check given two graphs are isomorphic or not. So first g1 and g2 are two graphs. So the number of vertices in g1 is 1 v1 v2 v3 v4. So the number of vertices of graph g1 is 4. And also number of vertices of graph G2 is also 4, and the number of edges P of G1 is equal to, so number of edges, how many edges in here? 3 edges, V1, V2, V3, V1 to V2, V2 to V3, V3 to V4. So number of edges is 3, okay? So in second graph also number of edges 3. So we go to next step. So the degree sequence of G1 is, so the degree sequence of G1 is how many vertices are in G1? V1, V2, V3, V4. So the degree of V1 is, the degree of V1 is 1 and the degree of V2 is 2. Okay. So 2 edges incident at V2. So the degree of V2 is 2 and 2 edges incident at V3. So the degree of V3 is 2 and the degree of V4 is 1. Only one edge incident at V4. So the degree of V4 is 1. So the degree sequence is 1, 2, 2, 1. Okay. Next, in graph G2, the degree sequence of the vertices U1, U2, U3, U4 is, so the degree sequence of U1, U2, U3, U4 is degree of U1. So one edge is incident at U1. So the degree of U1 is 1 and the degree of U2 is 1 and 2. So here 2 edges incident at U2. So U3 also degree 2. So here these 2 edges incident at U3 and the degree of U4 is 1. So the degree sequence of G2 is also 1, 2, 2, 1. So next we have to check vertex correspondence of two graphs. So first we consider vertex in G1. Okay, vertex in G1. So vertex in G1, we take the vertex V1. The corresponding vertex of V1 in G2 is U1. The corresponding vertex of V1 in G2 is U1, because the degree of V1 is 1 and also the degree of U1 is also 1. Okay, so the corresponding vertex of V1 is U1 and the corresponding vertex of V2 is U2. So the degree of V2 is 2 and the degree of U2 is also 2. So the corresponding vertex of V2 in G1 is U2. Okay. the corresponding vertex of V3 is U3 and the corresponding vertex of V4 is U4. So there is one correspondence between the two graphs. So V1 is corresponding vertex for U1 and V2 is corresponding vertex for U2 and V3 is corresponding vertex for U3 and V4 is corresponding vertex is U4 in G2. Okay. Now we have to check edge preserving. So edge preserving means, so now we check the edge in G1. So how many edges are there in G1? 3 edges. So the vertices, the adjacent vertices of that edge is V1, V2 and V2, V3 and V3, V4. So the edge preserving for this edge in G2 is, so V1 is corresponding vertex for U1 and V2 is corresponding vertex for U2. So V1, V2 edge is preserving for U1, U2. Okay. So here V1, V2 edge, the corresponding edge of V1, V2 in G2 is U1, U2. Okay. Next, V2, V3. So the edge, adjacent edge vertices are V2, V3. So for this edge, the corresponding edge in G2 is, so V2 vertex corresponding vertex is U2 in G2 and V3 vertex corresponding vertex in G2 is U3. So the edge corresponding of this edge is U2, U3 and also V3, V4. So the edge correspondence of this edge is U3, U4. Next we go check the adjacency matrix of G1. So the vertices are number of rows and number of columns n by n, V1, V2, V3, V4, V1, V2, V3, V4. So V1 doesn't have any self loop. So that place value is 0. So as V1 to V2 is an edge. So the place value is 1. V1 to V3, there is no an edge between V1, V3. So the place value is 0 and there is no an edge between V1 to V4. So the place value is 0. Okay. Next, V2 to V1. Yes, it has an edge between V2 to V1. That value is 1 and V2 doesn't have any self loop. So that value is 0 and V2 to V3, yes, there is an edge. So that value is 1 and V2 to V4, therefore there is no edge. So that value is 0. Next, V3 to V1, there is no edge. So that value is 0. V3 to V2, yes, it has an edge. So that value is 1. So V3 to V4. 3, there is no any self loop. So that value is 0. So V3 to V4. So the value is 1. So it has an edge between V3 to V4. So that value is 1. So V4. So V4 to V1, there is no any edge between V1 to V4 and V1 to V2. And V4 doesn't have any self loop. So the only possible value is V4 to V3 has an edge. So that value is 1 and remaining values are 0. This is the adjacency matrix for given graph G1. Okay. Similarly, we consider adjacency matrix for G2. So the number of rows and number of columns are U1, U2, U3, U4, U1, U2, U3, U4. Okay. So U1 doesn't have any self loop, so that value is 0 and there is an edge between U1 to U2, so that value is 1 and there is no edge between U1 to U3 and U1 to U4, so that values are 0, 0 and U2 to U1, yes, it has an edge, that value is 1 and U2 to U2, no self loop, so 0, U2 to U3, 1 and U2 to U4, 0. So no edge between U2 to U4. So U3, we consider U3. U3 to U1, no edge between U1 to U3. So 0. And U3 to U2, yes, it has an edge between U2 to U3. So that value is 1. and U3 to U3. So no self loop in the given graph. So 0 and U3 to U4. Yes, it has an edge. So that value is 1. So U4. U4 to U1. 0 and U4 to U2, 0. U4 to U3 only the edge. So 1. U4 to U4, 0. So this is the adjacency matrix for G2. Okay. So both the graph satisfies the 6 conditions mentioned above. So hence we can say that the given graph G1 is isomorphic to G2. It is denoted by G1 isomorphic to G2. Okay. So next topic is operations on graphs. So operations on graphs, in that first one, let G V comma E and G V1 comma E1 be two graphs that G V comma E and G V1 comma E1 be two graphs. So the first operation on graphs, union of G1 and G2. Union of G1 and G2. Okay. So what is union? What is the combine all vertices? Union means combining the all combining the all. So G1 and G2 are two graphs. The vertex set V1 union V2. So V1 is vertex set in G1 and V2 is vertex set in G2. So the combination of V1 union V2 and the edge set E1 union E2 is called the union of G1 and G2. So it is denoted by G1 union G2. So the what is the first operation on graph? Union of G1 and G2. So here G1 and G2 are two graphs, in that V1 union V2 and E1 union U2 gives the union of G1 and G2. It is denoted by G1 union G2. So the combined graph has vertices set V1 union V2 and E1 union E2. Okay. So let us consider an example. And the given first graph G1. So V1, V2, V3, V4, V5 and union second graph V1, V2, V6, V3, V4, it is G2. So the union of these two graphs, so totally how many vertices? V1 to V6. So V1, V2, V6 and V5, V3, V4, V5. Okay. So we draw V1 to V2, V1 to V2. Next, V2 to V6. V2 to V6, so V2 to V6. Next, V1 to V5, V1 to V4, V1 to V5, V1 to V4, and V2 to V4, and V2 to V3, V4. So V2 to V4 and V3. Okay, so the all edges, E1 union E2 and V1 union V2, it gives the union of given graphs G1 and G2. So this is the G1 union G2, union of given graphs G1 and G2. Okay. So second example, A, B, C, D. First graph G1 and union second graph B, D, E. Okay. So what is the vertices set of union A, B, C, D, E? So totally 5 vertices. So A, B, C, D, we consider here E. Okay. So what is the, how many edges are here? So A to B, A to B, and B to E, and B to D. So B to E and B to D, D to E, and C to D, A to C. This is the graph for union of given two graphs G1 and G2. So this is how we find the union of given graphs. Okay, we just combine all the vertices and all the edges of given two graphs. That gives the union of given graphs. Okay, so intersection. Second one, intersection. Intersection means common. Okay, so intersection of G1 and G2. So if G1 intersection V2 not equal to 5, the graph whose vertex set is V1 intersection V2 and edge set is E1 intersection E2 is called the intersection of G1 and G2. It is denoted by G1 intersection V2. So we common the vertex and edge in both the graphs. Okay, so look at the example. So given example is A, B, C, D. So edges E3, E4, E5, E6, and the second graph is A, B, C, and edges E1, E2, E3. So in both graphs G1 and G2, which vertex and which edge is common in both the graphs? So see here, A to B, A, B, A, B. These two vertices are common, and edge between A, B is E3. So A to B and between A, B is E3. This is. So the common graph is A to B, E3. E3 is edge. So remaining are not common in both the graphs. Okay. So A to C, E4 here. So here A to C, E1. Next B to C, there is no edge in first graph. So here B to C and edge E2. So we have to common the vertices with edge. So A to B, A, B are common vertices in both the graphs, and E3 is common edge between A, B in both the graphs. So the common graph is A, B, E3. Okay. This is the intersection of G1 and G2. So it is G1 intersection G2, which gives G1 intersection G2. Okay. Next, third operation, sum of G1 and G2. Sum means addition. So sum of G1 and G2. So let G1 has vertices set V1 and edge set E1, and G2 has vertices set V2 and edge set E2. B2 graphs and V1 intersection V2 not equal to 5 means no common vertices in the graph. The vertex set is V1 plus V2 and edge set is E1 plus E2, and edges obtained by joining each vertex of G1 to each vertex of G2. This is the condition. V1 plus V2 and edge set is E1 plus E2, and edges obtained by joining each vertex of G1 to each vertex of G2. That is called sum of the graphs. So look at the example. So G1 graph is U1, U2, and G2 graph is V1, V2, V3. Okay. So the sum of these two graphs is the edges is obtained. The edges is obtained by joining each vertex of U1, each vertex of G1 to each vertex of G2. So in first graph, the vertices are U1, U2. So each vertex of G1, so U1 to V1, U1 to V1 and u1 to v1 and u1 to v2 and u1 to v3. Same like that, u2 to v1, u2 to v2, u2 to v3. This is the sum of the given graphs u1 to u2, the edge joining each vertex of g1 to each vertex of g2, that is called sum of two graphs. Okay, so g1 plus g2 graph, the final graph of g1 plus g2 is here. Next one, next definition, ring sum. Ring sum, it is denoted by the symbol plus, rounded plus symbol, or triangle symbol. This symbol represents ring sum. Okay, g1 plus g2 or g1 triangle symbol g2. So in the graph, the vertex set v, edge set e, means v1 union v2 and e1 union e2 minus e1 intersection e2. We consider the edges that are in either g1 or in g2, but not both. Okay, this is the condition for ring sum. So v, vertices set, is taken union of two vertices, and edge set is taken u1 union u2 minus e1 intersection e2. So we consider the edges that are in either g1 or in g2, but not both. So common ga unnavi manamu draw cheyemu, either it is in g1 or in g2, but not both. Okay, so v1, v2, v6. So g1 has the vertices v1, v2, v6 and v5, v4, v3. Okay, minus v1, v2, v3, v4. First, we have to take a total vertices. How many vertices are there in two graphs? V1, v2, v3, v4, v5, v6. So we take the vertices v1, v2, v3. So six vertices, six dots we taken. V1, v2, v6, v3, v4, v5. And next, edge set. So what is the condition for edge set? E1 union E2 minus E1 intersection E2. So the common edges are removed from the edge set. So common vertices, edges from both the graphs is V1 to V2, V1 to V2. So we eliminate this edge from the final graph. Okay. So V1 to V2, we eliminate this edge, and V1 to V4. So V1 to V4, we eliminate this edge, and V2 to V3. So V2 to V3, we eliminate this edge, and V4 to V3. V4 to V3, there is no edge between V4 to V3 in final graph, and V4 to V2, there is no edge from V4 to V2 in final graph. This is the graph for ring sum of given two graphs. So we have to take a total vertices of two graphs, but in edge set, the union of edge set of both the graphs minus common edges in both the graphs. That means edges that are in either g1 or in g2, but not both. Okay, so common vertices ni remove chestamu. Two graphs lo common ga evaithe unnayo, we have to remove those edges from the graph. So we get the final graph is like this. So v1, v2, v6, v3, v4, v5. So next one, product of g1 and g2. So product is denoted by multiplication symbol g1 into g2. So the product of the graph has the vertex set V of G1 into G2. So G1, vertices set of first graph into vertices set of second graph. Edge set E of G1 into G2, that is equal to, the condition is V of G1 into E of G2, cross multiplication here, okay? V of G1 into E of G2 union V of G2 into E of G1. This is the condition for edge set, okay? So first we have to take vertices set and next edge set. So let us see an example. So in the given example, G1 graph is A, B has two vertices A and B with an edge U, and the second graph has three vertices 0, 1, 2 with two edges E, F. So we have to draw graph of these product of the graphs. Okay. So first we consider the vertices set of G1. V of G1 is equal to A comma B. E of G1 is equal to the only edge U, singleton set U, and V of G2. So the edge set, the vertices of G2 is 0, 1, 2, and the edge set of G2 is E comma F. So the first property is, what is the vertex property? V of G1 into G2. So that set has A into 0. So A comma 0, A comma 1, and A comma 2. Okay. So B comma 0 and B comma 1 and B comma 2. This is vertex set of the product of the graphs. And the edge set. So E of G1 into G2 is equal to, so what is the condition? V of G1 into E of G2. V of G1 into E of G2. So cross multiply. So cross multiplication. A comma E and A comma F. B comma E comma B comma F. Union V of G2 into E of G1. So 0 comma U, 1 comma U, 2 comma U. So this is the edge set of the product of the given graphs G1 and G2. So we consider the graph first. So how many vertices are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I take the node points 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like this. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So first vertex A comma 0 and A comma 1 and A comma 2. Next B comma 0, B comma 1, B comma 2. This is the vertices set. So go to edge set. So the edge between A comma E. So here in this, A represents the vertex, E is the edge. Okay. A represents the vertex and E is the edge. So here E is in between 0, 1 vertex. So A comma 0, A comma 1. The between edge is A comma E. Okay. A comma 0, A comma 1. The edge is E. So A comma E. Next, A comma F. So F is the edge between 1, 2. Here, the vertex is A. So A comma 1, A comma 2. The edge is A comma F. Next, B comma E. So B comma E, E is in between 0 comma 1. So here B common in this. So the edge between B comma E is an edge between B comma 0 and B comma 1. So B comma F is an edge between B comma 1 and B comma 2. Okay. Next 0 comma U, 1 comma U, 2 comma U. So here 0 is the vertex and U is the edge. U is in an edge between A comma B. So we consider vertex A comma B and 0. So the edge is in between A comma 0 and B comma 0. So the edge is in between A comma 1 and B comma 1, 1 comma U. Next, A comma 2, B comma 2. These are the vertices and 2 comma U is the edge. So this edge is in between A comma 2 and B comma 2. This is the product of the given two graphs. So product of G1, G2, the final graph is here. Okay. Next, complement of graphs. So complement of graphs. So G and G dash are two graphs with the same vertex set. With the same vertex set. If two vertices V1 and V2 adjacent only when they are not adjacent in G. Okay. So ikkada em cheptunnarante G1 and G and G dash are two graphs with the same vertex set. If two vertices V1 and V2, V1 and V2 adjacent only. Adjacent means the edge between, there is an edge between V1 and V2 when they are not adjacent in G. Okay. So ikkada graph chudandi. A given graph, star graph charu. So U, V, W, X, Y, Z. So complement ante ichina graph U, V ki edge ledu. Here U and V are not adjacent. So ikkada G complement lo U, V adjacent avutundi. So that is the condition. V1 and V2 adjacent only when they are not adjacent in given graph G. So here U and V are not adjacent in given graph G. So V1 and V2 are, U and V are adjacent in G complement. Okay. So V and VW is not adjacent here. So V and VW are adjacent in G complement. Okay. W and X not adjacent in G. W and X adjacent in G complement. X and Y not adjacent in G. X and Y adjacent in G complement. Y and Z not adjacent in G. Y, Z are adjacent in G dash. Adjacent means there is an edge between these two vertices. Then we say that these two vertices are adjacent vertices. Okay. So given graph low adjacent kaagudu. అది మనకి జీ కాంప్లిమెంట్ లో అడ్జసెంట్ అవ్వాలి, అదే కండిషన్. ఓకేనా? ఎక్స్ అండ్ వై ఆర్ అడ్జసెంట్ ఓన్లీ వెన్ దే ఆర్ నాట్ అడ్జసెంట్ ఇన్ జీ. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద కండిషన్. సో హియర్ ఎక్స్ వై ఆర్ నాట్ అడ్జసెంట్ ఇన్ జీ, బట్ ఎక్స్ వై ఆర్ అడ్జసెంట్ ఇన్ జీ కాంప్లిమెంట్. వై జెడ్ ఆర్ నాట్ కాంప్లిమెంట్ నాట్ అడ్జసెంట్ ఇన్ జీ. వై అండ్ వై జెడ్ ఆర్ అడ్జసెంట్ ఇన్ జీ కాంప్లిమెంట్. ఓకే. So this is the complement graph of given graph. Last operation, fusion of graphs or merged of graphs or identified graphs. So V1 and V2 are two vertices in graph G is said to be fused if these two vertices are replaced by a single new vertex V such that every edge that was adjacent to either V1 or V2 or both is adjacent to V. So V1 and V2 are any two vertices in given graph G, but these two vertices are replaced by a new vertex V. Okay, if two vertices place low, one vertex ni replace chaste V anedi vati adjacent replaced by a single new vertex V such that every edge that was adjacent to either V1 or V2. So V1 toti adjacent aina edge and V2 toti adjacent aina edge both is adjacent to that new vertex, that is called fusion of the graph. Okay. So example chudandi. V1, V2, V3, V4. This is the given graph. So any two vertices manam consider cheyachu. Nenu v1 v2 ni fused graph consider chestunanu. So v1 v2 ki v1 v2 plus ikkada v1 v2 are two different vertices. In place of these two vertices we replace with new vertex, that is v. Okay, sorry, we take v1 v4. So v1 v4 are two different vertices, and these two vertices are replaced by another vertex, so that another vertex is v1 v4. So another name v1 v4, and the edges of these vertices is v1 to v4 and v1 to v3. So v1 to v4, so v1 to v4 it has a self loop, and remaining vertices v3 v2, v3 v2. So there is an edge between v4 to v3. So v4 to v3 and v1 to v3. So v1 to v3 and v1 to v4. So v1 to v4. Here v4 to v3 is two edges. So we draw two edges for v4 to v3 and v3 to v2. So v3 to v2. So this is a fused graph of given graph G. So here V1 is fused with V4. Okay.